What's the mode of breath? It's special body. And today we are going to do a new water topic of Naruto, of course. So it is water Naruto saved Karin instead of Sasuke. So if you guys don't understand what this topic is, I'll explain it right now. So without any further ado, let's get watching. So Karin is a woman who's like, she's a healing type, and she's an Uzumaki, most importantly, and she's a healing type. She meets Sasuke in the Chunin exams. Sasuke just saves her from a bear. For that she develops a huge ass crush on him, just like Sakura. She just tries to get Sasuke's attention. So Naruto's gonna easily give her attention because Naruto's just like an attention seeker himself. So he can kind of relate to Karin, but that's not important. So Karin is she's also on the team with Sasuke, his hawk team, which comprised of Orochimaru's underlings, so they could find Itachi and kill him, in the arc of where the Konoha was getting destroyed. But anyways, so what if Naruto saved Karin instead of Sasuke? So the incident that happens is Karin gets saved by Sasuke when Naruto's peeing, okay? So that's why it doesn't go apart from the canon normal part. So we're just gonna switch some roles. When Naruto is peeing, he gets attacked by two ninja and Sasuke saves Karin. But in this time, Naruto saves Karin and Sasuke gets attacked by two. Sasuke and Sakura gets attacked by two ninja. So Naruto is peeing when it's really weird saying that, but Naruto is peeing and when he hears a voice, a screaming voice, Naruto quickly zips his back up after peeing because peeing is very important. Naruto runs quickly and sees a bear going to kill a girl. Naruto jumps and stomps on him because Naruto is basically as powerful. Even though Naruto isn't as powerful as Sasuke, he's still quite a lot powerful, and Sasuke just one shot the bear, so even Naruto could one shot the bear. And Karin, who just lost her glasses because she was scared and her glasses, she threw her glasses somewhere. She was finding her glasses she was trying to find where her glasses were. So Naruto, jumped out of the bear which he just jumped on, and goes to the, what is it? Aisle? I forgot what spectacle. Goes to the, I just forgot what this, for. Oh my god, I forgot specs, yeah, specs. Goes to Karin specs, picks it up and gives it to Karin. Karin puts it up and sees Naruto. And she thanks Naruto for, saving him. Naruto's like, no problem. And Naruto asks what Karin's name is. Because Naruto, whenever he meets people, he likes to ask his name. Because we know in the land of the land of waves, Naruto just asked an unknown person's name. So I don't think Naruto wouldn't ask here also. Karin was, I am Karin Uzumaki. Naruto would be shocked. Uzumaki? He's happy that they both surnames are same, as well as doubtful. Why is this girl name Uzumaki, and he's happy for both surname being there. So Naruto's like, I'm Naruto Uzumaki. And Karin's like, you are Uzumaki too. She explains with the question face. Naruto's like, yeah, is that wrong? Naruto says, and Karin's like, no, I just wanted to ask. And Karin mumbles, so there are more of the clan here, huh? Naruto hears and asks, clan? What clan? Because Karin's like, Uzumaki is a clan, you don't know that? Naruto's shocked. Uzumaki were a clan? He explains, yeah, what did you think of it? Naruto's like, I thought it was just a surname or like other people's surname. I didn't think it was a clan. Karin is like, oh, but it's a clan, so I think now you know it. Naruto's like, he has this really thing, his mind is completely boggled right now. First, he's like a clan member, and he has like, they both are in the same clan, so he doesn't just know what the hell is happening right now, because it's like someone betrayed him, okay, like Third Hokage betrayed him. No, Naruto's angry at Third Hokage right now, because number one, he didn't tell him who his father and mother were. Number two, he didn't tell him that it was Kyuubi inside of him. And number three, he didn't tell him that he had a clan. So Naruto was like pissed off, and but he didn't show it. He wanted to think it later. So Naruto said, "So where is your gang, your team?" Kiren, you know, just nervously, you know, pushes up her specs. It's called specs, right? Yeah, glasses. She puts puts up a glass. She does her nervous thing and says that she got lost. Naruto's like, then come with us, I'll help you, you know, get to your team. And we can, you know, talk about the Uzumaki clan, because I really don't know anything about it. So Naruto's like, I also don't know much about it, but my mother told me something, so I can talk with that. And Naruto stands up and offers Karin a hand. Karin blushes and takes it. And yeah, Naruto, you know, brings back Karin with her. Sasuke and Sakura are like, who is that girl? Naruto doesn't want to say she's Uzumaki, so Naruto just says that she found him in the woods and she wanted to help him. Sasuke is like, they don't have time for that. But Naruto's like, we have a week of it. A week, right? Of 3 days a week. Yeah. So let's just go to the end part and let's see if her group is there or not. And yeah, if you guys don't know, Karin's group is there on the end side waiting. They have one school and Karin has one other school. So it goes. Naruto's kind of conflicted right now, because he's just thinking. Naruto and Karin keep talking, and Sasuke and Sakura, like, they are ahead of them because they don't want to, you know, have interest in talking. Sakura is just seeing about Naruto, you know, being happy. It confuses Sakura, because Naruto hasn't been this happy before. Sasuke also sees it, but he's like, I don't care, kind of suffering that. And Naruto and Karin, you know, talk about Uzumaki. I mean, Karin just tells what she knows about the Uzumakis. Uzumakis normally have red hair and black eyes, but Naruto is different. He has blonde hair and blue eyes. So Naruto thinks that he might be in hybrid, and Naruto's like, yeah. And Naruto asks Karin about her ability, you know, she has a Keke Genkai or something like that, because Naruto also wants to know if the Uzumakis have a Keke Genkai. Karin, you know, hesitates for a bit and just says that they don't have a Keke Genkai, but some of them have an ability, you know, a different kind of ability. They're just born different. Naruto understands, because he has been, you know, ridiculed for him being the 9th Jinchuriki. So, and Karin says that she has an ability which heals people very quickly, but they have to bite the hand. And Karin, you know, trusting Naruto, shows her bite marks. You know, Naruto is shocked and asks Karin what her real story is. Now, Karin, you know, was about to say what her story is, but then Orochimaru comes up. And Orochimaru still, you know, thinks that Sasuke. And Orochimaru, you know, when he sees Karin, he's confused, like, why is there another team member? Why is there another girl in this team? But Orochimaru doesn't really put some mind, because he wants Sasuke. And the snake comes and tries to bite Naruto and Karin. But due to Karen's, you know, high sensory ability, because she's basically a sensor, she tells Naruto to dodge, and they both dodge, so they get fined from the, snake. And Naruto's quickly sucked into his mindscape, okay? So this is where Naruto meets Kurama for the first time. He doesn't know it's Kurama, he's like the Ninetales. Naruto is now pretty confused about where he is, and when he goes forward, he sees a big cage, and there he sees red eyes. Naruto instantly figures out where he is, and he asks, "Why? What do you want, Fox?" Kurama's like, "Don't call me that, you dumb idiot." Naruto's like, "Just why did you call me? I'm basically gonna die, and you're calling me right now." Then Kurama's like, "I just need to say that I know about your past, and it ain't pretty good." Naruto's like, "You know about my what?" Kurama's like, "Well, basically put, your mother was the last keeper of me." "My ma?" Kurama cuts him off and sends him back to his real body. Naruto jumped and landed down. He's pretty angry, confused, and kind of scared because Orochimaru is giving out his bloodlust. And Naruto's like, "What the f-?" He asks, then he shouts in his mind, "Hey, you damn fox, tell me what you're trying to say. Continue." And the snake attacks Naruto again, but due to Naruto being pissed off, he jumps and punches the snake, and then goes, and him and Karin is astounded about how powerful Naruto is. Karin says that we need to find the other two crewmates of Naruto. Naruto quickly says okay, and they both go to Sasuke. And Sasuke and the Orochimaru's fight just happens like in the original, but when Sasuke is going to be beaten, Naruto comes in with a dropkick. And Orochimaru, seeing this, gets sided away, Naruto's pretty pissed off. First someone tries to harm Sasuke, second this damn fox says that he knows about his entire race, his entire clan, and his mother was a Jinchuriki before him. Naruto's pretty pissed off, and this pissed off Kurama is like, "Yo, take my chakra," and Naruto envelops in his one-tailed cloak form. Okay, you might be asking what he would have gone to half-tailed cloak form, but I will say you go to one-tailed cloak form because Kurama is excited about what is going to happen, and Kurama says that he wants to spice some things a bit. So Kurama thinks that he has to wait for the correct time to say it to him, and Naruto and Orochimaru starts battling. Naruto, who is pretty pissed, has Kurama's rage and Kurama's chakra. And Kurama ain't sucking his chakra, so Naruto has his own chakra, Kurama's chakra, and he has the rage boost. So yeah, Orochimaru ain't doing that well. He's not getting busted or something. He has a little trouble, just a little trouble with Naruto. But Orochimaru quickly figures out that he is the Nine-Tails Jinchuriki, and comes to seal the things that. But Kurama is like, "No." And then just a second before Naruto gets his stomach touched by Orochimaru. I know that sounds disgusting, but you guys understand what I'm trying to say. Kurama quickly sucks in Naruto and says that Orochimaru was the one who killed his parents. Okay, it was a lie, okay? But Naruto, being like conflicted and kind of stuck, just believes Kurama because he just can't do anything, okay? He's in Kurama's rage, his rage, and Kurama's chakra is boiling, coming out of him. So that's kind of changing his mentality to think rationally, think logically. And plus, he's in a dire situation. So Naruto believe that what Orochimaru was the one who killed his parents. And Orochimaru. Yes, super gone. Gone like hell. Naruto goes enraged, four-tailed right off the bat. And Kurama doesn't influence Naruto because he wants to see how Naruto can do on his own. Because he's like super interested about what is happening, and he wants to get free. And Kurama decides that this is the only option of Naruto, you know, letting him free and kind of stuff like that. So basically Kurama is, you know, trying to use Naruto's mental state right now because it's very weak. Naruto goes four-tailed and he doesn't consume him. He's just rowdy, you know. Naruto attacks the entirety of Orochimaru, and Karin is scared. I mean, scared as hell. Sakura is scared, and they both, you know, hug each other for comfort because they both are just like that. And Sasuke is, you know, amazed about how speed this match is going on and how powerful Naruto's chakra is, because Naruto's chakra is like 20 times more than his own chakra. So now, Sasuke is getting a bit jealous, but he just cuts it, the jealousy out, because he knows that it isn't time for that, because this is a life or death battle, and that guy Orochimaru basically is, you know, behind him. And now let's go to the fight between Naruto and Orochimaru. Orochimaru got off by this huge ass chakra pull and got off guard, and Naruto used it to slash Orochimaru's, you know, sides, and Orochimaru didn't, you know, react correctly, so it stayed a scar, because Orochimaru had to instantly, you know, suck his body out of that body to regenerate, but Orochimaru, due to being off guarded for a couple of seconds, can't do it. And Naruto, who saw this, you know, thought that he could take advantage of it, and Naruto, you know, sends out more chakra out of his body to, you know, make bloodless, and it is a huge bloodless. Orochimaru shivering, okay? So it's like the rage of Kurama, the rage of Naruto, the rage of Naruto against Hiruzen, and the rage of Orochimaru Orochimaru to attack Sasuke, and the rage to Orochimaru for killing his family, I guess. So yeah, that's a huge ass bloodlust. Karin, Sakura drop down, knocked out. Sasuke, you know, goes to his knees, because, well, even Orochimaru is shivering, so Sasuke goes down to his knees, but he tries to stay conscious, which unlocks his three Tomoe Sharingan. Naruto roars, and with enhanced speed, starts slashing Orochimaru. He quickly uses a Shadow Clone Jutsu and pummels Orochimaru. And Kurama, you know, wants to, you know, quickly finish off Orochimaru, because he hates Orochimaru. So he's like, yo, Naruto, defeat this guy, I'll help you. And Kurama sucks Naruto up again and says Naruto that he would teach him one technique, so to use it. Naruto's like, sure, teach me quickly. And Kurama shows some symbols which Naruto quickly copies, because Naruto's pretty much in rage, and Naruto, you know, has a high potential of learning things. And enhanced by Kurama's chakra, so boom. And that, Naruto comes to his real life, which only passed the second. Orochimaru's in the sky. Naruto thinks that his clones are, then he makes more shadow clones, much more shadow clones, like 300 shadow clones, and it all surrounds Orochimaru. Orochimaru doesn't know what to do, and Naruto makes hand sign, which basically makes Orochimaru shiver. He wants to escape, but he can't escape, because this all things going speed. You know, the speed is so much. And Sasuke, who's just trying to catch up with these two, because the speed is enormous and the bloodlust is enormous. Sasuke, compares this bloodlust to Itachi, and Itachi's bloodlust now doesn't come close to this bloodlust. And you know what? To give Sasuke a bone, he unlocks the Mangekyo Sharingan in this, you know, bloodlusting battle, because Naruto is going all out right now, you know, and his body can muster. Naruto uses a jutsu and says, wind style, wind bullet, jutsu, a 150 of them do, and the other 150 of them says, wind style, great breakthrough. And with 150 great breakthroughs and 150 wind bullets, yeah, Orochimaru ain't surviving from that. Yeah, I want to make Orochimaru live and Sasuke get the curse mark, but Even I don't think Jiraiya would be able to do that. Yeah, and Orochimaru, who has got off guard all the entire of the battle, Orochimaru doesn't even have a chance. So Orochimaru dies. Naruto, you know, after killing Orochimaru, you know, comes out of his QB form and starts falling. Sasuke regains his composure, and Sakura and Karin, you know, get up of their danger state after pissing themselves. Karin is scared, but she still owes her life to Naruto. And after seeing Naruto, you know, protect someone, Karin, you know, gets a little scared and a respect for Naruto, because Naruto, you know, focuses more priority on saving other people than himself. You know, Karin just thing gets a thought like that. And Sasuke, you know, quickly gets up and starts running. Doesn't run in the opposite direction, runs towards Naruto and catches him. Because, yeah, and Naruto, you know, Sasuke sees his speed has grown a lot. Sasuke doesn't understand what is going on and his eyes are paining. So Sasuke thinks that his eyes have evolved into the three-tomo Sharingan. But when he comes back, Sakura points out his eyes have taken a weird shape instead of the tamoe shape. Sasuke is confused, and when he, you know, makes a mirror jutsu and sees his hand starts shaking, and he drops the mirror. Sasuke realizes that he got the Mangekyo Sharingan, but then he doesn't know how he got it. He thought he would get the three tomoe Sharingan, but then he realizes the whole bloodlust thing and the last jutsu that Naruto used. Yeah. That made Sasuke, you know, activate his Mangekyo Sharingan. Okay, so why, if you guys are asking why when Sasuke has unlocked his Mangekyo Sharingan here, and you need to because you guys think that you need to kill someone precious to you to unlock the Mangekyo Sharingan, that's only Itachi only said that. That's not true. All you have, you know, it is compatible to two types. Number one, to feel pressure that you think that your life is there, you are going to die any second now, and the number two is seeing your loved ones, you know, almost to die. So you don't have to kill anyone for that. And Sasuke unlocks Mangekyo Sharingan out of the bloodlust. He doesn't have that still bond of with Naruto. And Naruto, you know, is like Naruto. I mean, Sasuke is like, he whispers thank you, and Naruto, who's fainted, can't hear it, and Sasuke starts walking with Naruto on his back and says to Sakura to carry Sakura and Karin to come with them. And they, you know, start walking, and when the sound trio comes, Sasuke quickly handles with them. Sasuke puts down Naruto because he's tired, because his eyes were bleeding. So Sasuke doesn't pass out, he's just like, he's low on chakra, and Karin doesn't really know what to do. Okay, so she keeps her ability secret for now, because she doesn't really want to show them. She wants to show to Naruto, but she really doesn't want to show them. So Karin is a bit of pickle, but soon the three ninja comes, and Sakura comes for, and Karin comes to save Naruto. Sasuke tries to get up, but Sakura, you know, just says to sit it out and let them handle it. Sakura, you know, has the same battle with that girl, and when she was going to cut off her hair, she sees Karin, who's beat up that sound guy, the sound guy, Dosu's team, the other guy of the Dosu's team. And she's fighting Dosu in Taijutsu. Sakura sees how the level of fighting combat, and she gets inspiration to, you know, she not let a girl, you know, make her how she outclass her. So Sakura, you know, doesn't cut her hair, but she stabs that woman's leg, which she should have done, and she gets up and takes the kunai, which was stabbed in her leg, and stabs in her heart, which kills her. So Dosu, the other guy, and all three of Dosu's members are killed. And luckily for their team, they get the scroll what they deserve. And Naruto, you know, wakes up a little injured, but is quite okay. Karin goes and hugs him, and Naruto is kind of confused, but hugs her back. Sasuke and Sakura are like confused. Does both of them have a thing or something? But they don't take care of it, and Naruto, Karin, Sasuke and Sakura start walking to the end, and they don't meet Kabuto, but they don't take the alliance because the team has all the thing they need. Yeah, all the scrolls they need. And I forgot to mention that Orochimaru didn't take the scroll because Naruto came just in time, and Sakura didn't give up their scroll to save Sasuke. So yeah, and when they meet, Yamcha? No, what is his name? Yamcha? No, no, the guy with the specs of Orochimaru. He's one of Orochimaru's son. Yamato. Yeah, anyways, Inito, that guy, I forgot his name, that specs guy, American Ninjutsu, Nagato, no, it's, fuck, I don't care. So, he, Naruto and this gang, reject his proposal, and he's kind of angry, but he doesn't show it. And he's like, yo, Orochimaru, signalized him, maybe did to him. And, Naruto, and they reach the end of the... They reach the end of the stage where Karin sees her team members. They go to the, she goes to them showing her scroll. They show the other scroll, and coincidentally, they both have this. They both have the scroll they need. So they both go in. Now Karin says goodbye to Naruto and her team. They both wave her head back. Sasuke just acknowledges her, and yeah. Naruto gonna goes to his room his interaction with Iruka goes, he doesn't go the same, he's conflicted, so he just acknowledges Iruka, doesn't jump and hug into him, just like Sasuke acknowledges Iruka, Naruto acknowledges Iruka by nodding it. Sasuke sees this and he's a little bit confused about what happened to Naruto because he knows that now how Naruto likes Iruka, but he really doesn't question that. Naruto goes to his allotted room and sits on the bed and starts sleeping. And he gets pulled into Kurama's space, and Naruto says, "Talk," and that's Naruto says, "Start talking," and that's where we're gonna leave for this episode, guys. If you guys like this video, like, subscribe, doing this stuff, and if you're not, I can understand. So peace out.